Alright, I think this is the last video here, guys. I think I will continue on with my ceremony. Just meditating, completing my intentions, completing my witch's salt. My moon, my water is outside by the light of the moon. And that's one thing that I did want to mention. If you guys want to make some moon water for yourself, I strongly encourage you to do that. I think it's magical and fabulous. But I would just like to note that you should ideally bring your moon water in before the sun comes up. So, if the sun comes up and it's not that your moon water is ruined, it's just that it's become now celestial water. It has the energies of both the moon and the sun. And for me personally, what I'm trying to do is harness sort of the energy and frequency of this full pink moon. So I'm not going to be leaving mine out to be infused with the sun. Maybe tomorrow or sometime this weekend, we can sort of go over a few uses for moon water, what I plan on doing with my moon water. If you're interested in that, you can let me know, leave me a comment if you've gotten this far in this little series. I really, really, really enjoyed sharing a little bit of my practice with you guys. If this is something that you are interested in, let me know. And I will be happy to continue to create more sort of, I wouldn't call it content, but create more sort of little videos like this just to show you, how I do things and hopefully be able to inspire you in your own practice. Thank you so much, everybody, for your time. I hope that you all have a lovely full moon and a lovely long weekend. Take care, everyone.